So, good morning, everyone. At the beginning, excuse me for my English. I didn't talk since a while, so excuse me. So my name is Walid Amokran. I am a robotic engineer at Orano Lag. And today, with my colleague Jean-François Trot, we will present you some robotic application that we made at the Orano Lag. So this presentation is divided in two parts. In the first one, I will present what we made on the factory at Lag. A recent application that we made during the last two, three years. And then my colleague will present some robotic application with industrial robot exclusively for dismantling application. So why we use a robotic system for nuclear industry? Of course, the main objective is to reduce cost because of we lost a lot of money because of breakage of some mechanical system. So the goal is to increase MTBF, so mean time between failure of our system. And the second part is to reduce maintenance cost. And both of them will reduce waste technological waste. And moreover, we contribute to improve the health of the operator, to protect the operator by reduce the personal dosimetry, improve technical performance, and optimize the workspace and the working space of the operator. So different applications of robotic are made at Orano Lag, and I will give you some example. We use a robotic system for operating, for example, control no contamination of barrel, brushing vitrified barrel, chasing operation, and CSDC cap welding. We use also robotic systems and automation systems for maintenance, for example, for make a different inspection, for repair evaporator, and dissolver wheel maintenance. So I'm giving you here some application that we made at Orano. And of course, for dismantling, for example, for recovery and sorting of historical waste and cutting operation equipment. So now I will present you one of the most system used at Orano Lag and how we did to improve this technology in the robotic system. At Orano Lag, we use exclusively one of the most devices that we use on the factory today is the mechanical wall arm, as we shown on this picture. This mechanical wall arm is composed of a master arm and a slave arm. So of course, the master arm, the operator teleoperate the starting from the master arm, and he can make some operation in the hardest area with the slave arm. So we have this mechanical system. So we have an important how-know on many termination, and all our operators are formed with training to teleoperation. For example, for vitrification cell, we form them. We train them during one day to make vitrification for vitrification cell, and for example for dismantling, we train them during 3 days for a specific operation. And today we have more than 800 operators trained on teleoperation. And I give you some key figure. So we have 507 MT200 arm and 134 A100 arm from Wallis-Schmiller. So we have a how-know about mechanical system, and we try to improve this system in order to reduce cost of maintenance and risk of breakage. So we improved this mechanical system by two solutions. So by introduced some electrical systems in electronical components, sorry, on the mechanical system to make them more smart, and then we can collect a lot of data of of the position of several articulation of our master arm and slave arm, and with an algorithm, we identify the risk of the breakage and how the operator have to do to limit the risk of the breakage of our arm. And the second solution that we made consists of replace the master arm, like showed you before, by a new system composed of motor block and a new electrical master arm. So the system is composed like this. So on the hot cell, the system stayed the same. So we have the slave arm and a camera. And in the cold zone, when the operator make the work, so we change the master arm by a motor block, engine block, we see in the picture, connected to the electrical bay, which is also connected with the new master arm. So let me show you some video of the deployed system. So just excuse me of the quality of the video. I'm not here to show you a commercial video, but to show you the reality of the operation. So this is an operator, he's Denis. So he worked on the vitrification cell, and he make many things, and one of them consists of brush the baron, like we see on the video here. So since July 2021, we implemented the new master arm from Apption in order to make possible and more easily this manipulation. On this video, we cannot feel it, because with a mechanical system, the brush, when we actuated the brush, we have some vibration felt by the operator with the mechanical part. But with an electrical system, we avoided all this perturbation, and now the operator can make the operation easily without any disturbance. So we deployed the system on the field, and we can also control the master arm now from a driving room. So we have around 700 meters from the hot cell. And now the operator, so he activates the brush with the like we see here, and he's still operating the new the slave arm with the new master arm. So he positioned the brush on the upper of the barrel. He find the perfect position of the slave arm. Then he can make now pause, and he wait that until the barrel make one turn. And if he didn't choose a right position, so he can take again the new control of the slave arm, and find a new position of new stable position of the master arm. Here I present you a new slave arm that we developed. So this is the Therman robot, Therman arm, that we deployed on ACC, Atelier de Compactage des Coques. So I can show you more about this application for some confidential reason. But with this system and with this new arm, we are able to make teleoperation and to plan some trajectory of our robot. So we called it telerobotic. So we match the term teleoperation and the robotic system. So you have the double function. So what I presented now, we can use it for operating, for maintenance, and for dismantling. Now I will show you the ORNF drone that we use only for maintenance. ORNF is a drone. This is a foldable drone. So we use it to introduce the drone on the cell, hole of 100 millimeter. When the drone is in the cell, we can open it remotely. So we have a remote. So the drone is unfoldable now, and we can actuate it, the motor and make an inspection, visual inspection on the cell, or make a non-destructive control of our equipment, or make a measurement, a radiological measurement of the cell. So the autonomy of the drone is around 20 minutes, and it was developed by our support iAccess. So I will show you in this video an example of the operation with the drone. So this is supposed to be the cockpit. So now we have two holes on the wall. The first one is used to introduce a camera and the device communication. And in the second one, we introduce the foldable drone on an articulated pole. And when the drone is on the cell, we put the drone on the ground. Then we open it with the pilot and the co-pilot. And this is the video of the drone inside the cell. And we have the camera of the environment. So the pilot actuates the drone and he makes an inspection operation on the cell. So now we have an example of visual inspection on a hot cell.
Okay, thank you, Walid. So, Walid talked to you about the wall arm that I used in a nuclear facility for exploitation. This arm was made specifically for nuclear application. I will talk now about the use and development around industrial robots that are used every day in industry. And the implementation of this industrial robot in the nuclear dismantling operation. So I will talk about more specifically about dismantling operation. Dismantling operation recover many, many situations that are very different, and we have to face new situations every day. For example, here you have a few pictures of a silo with a lot of waste in a silo. You also have some small cells, very hot cells, in terms of radiation, but very narrow. It's very difficult to work inside to introduce a robot or to cut this installation. Or on the contrary, you will have some very big cells, 15 meters long, 12 meters high. And then also in these cells, we have to face many situations to cut, recover all the part we have cut and put them in drums. So to do this, of course, the wall arm MT200 Terman TAO will be a part of the solution. But we also think that the use on nuclearization of the industrial robot will be a part of the solution. The telerobotic, so using a robot, is already done since 2005 in the facility of LAG but for exploitation and for maintenance. So it means for operations that are can be prepared and they are made every year. And so we have time to prepare the operation, and we know what we have to face as situation. In dismantling operation, this is not the case. So it's more difficult to use the robot. Instead, in fact, we think that robots, industrial robots, have a lot of advantage. They have a very good precision, a good repeatability, very high rigidity, high mean time between failure, low cost, and many applications are also already existing in the industry. So we want to use all this, not to redevelop a new solutions. But of course, the implementation requires a long preparation, and especially a special adjustment to define trajectory in an environment we don't really know. This is our challenge. So the two solutions I will talk now a little bit in detail are two solutions, one telerobotic and one purely robotics. So the telerobotics, it's very close to what we have already seen with Walid, with Terman TAO or MT200 TAO. But instead of using wall arm, we use a robot, industrial robot. It means that here you can see that the robot from industry, here our stubby robot, is piloted by the operator with a force feedback master arm. So this development was made by Orano Temis, and that to improve the robot to be able to work in a teleoperation with this system. The other solution we will detail a little bit is named DeRosa. It's a development we made with our partner Cilean. The aim here is to use really the robot as a robot. I mean in automatic mode. So we will be able to, in that case, to use all the high performance of the robot. So in that case, we are in a robotic mode. Some details about the TO600, so the telerobotic system made by Orano Temis. So you can see, as already shown, that the operator will guide the pilot robot with a force feedback master arm. So the operator will feel every contact he will have with the environment. So in fact, in that case, he doesn't need to know the environment because the operator sees and feels what he's doing. For this, Temis we see modify a little bit the robot to be able to increase the payload from 24 kilogram until 60 kilogram. In this case, with a Stobli RX 150, the robot can now have a payload of 60 kilogram for operation. And is also modified to be able to absorb a dose, very high dose of 1 megagray. So the system, which was developed for exploitation, Temis and Orano has worked on it to adapt many solutions and processes to be able to use it in dismantling operation. Dismantling operation, it means mainly cutting. So we will adapt different cutting tools, chiseling, for example, also, or manipulating tank or case. You see a specific development from Temis to be able to use the robot by learning one point at the beginning, one point at the end, and the system follows the surface automatically, for example, here for plasma or oxy-cutting. So many tools have been adapted to face many situations for dismantling operation. Okay. The other system I want to talk to you is a system so by using the robot only in automatic mode. So you can ask, use a robot in automatic mode, it's not really a revolution, because it is why the robot is made. Okay, but in fact, what we want to do is to use and introduce the robot in a room, and then we don't know where the system is, so we cannot define a trajectory, automatic mode, because we don't know where the system is placed in the cell, or when we go through the dismantling operation, the system moves into the cell. So each time, we have to learn again where the system is to be able to learn a new trajectory. So the aim is to integrate the robot into an unknown and evolving environment. This is important. We don't know where we are. But we want to be able to define the trajectory of the robot so it will be able to work automatically. Okay, only 5 minutes. I accelerate. I just want to show you quickly how the system works. It works in four main steps. The first one, and the most important, I would say, is to learn about the environment. And to learn about the environment, it means that we will mix. If it's working, yeah, we'll mix what we know about the robot, some the situation of the cell. But what we don't know is the situation of the robot and the way where it's going to work on. So we are going to scan precisely the environment when we want the robot works. I go quickly. When we mix all this information and we have a digital twin, this is important, the digital twin, the operator will be able to define a trajectory. Is it working? Okay, yeah. Here, very easily, the operator can define the trajectory, the first point, the second point, and then the trajectory is automatically drawn by the HMI. And so we will be able to work in automatic mode. Then the system will check that all the positions are reachable and that there is no collision. Sorry, I have to go quickly now. And when all these checks are okay, then the system is launched and we can do the operation on the trajectory here with the cutting tool automatically. Then we have really the benefit of all the high performance of the robot. The rigidity, the speed control, the force control into the matter, and so on. So this is the aim, to be able to use all the performance of the industrial robot. Here it is a Stobli, it can be a KUKA, a FANUC, or other systems. This video I will go through, it is the same thing. I just show you this slide to tell you that we have already implemented different processes, but we are continuing and we want to integrate new tools, for example, laser tools. Here you can see, for example, the laser simulation and the laser test, plasma, flame cutting, touch nibbler. We also will integrate other functions, for example, a function that already exists in the industry but we don't use already, is the bin picking to take a waste from a bulk. 3D supervision for our telerobotic system. We can also think that we can pair the scan with a nuclear measurement, so we will be able to know where the hot points are and to manage this. For example, it can be a decontamination before we cut, or on the contrary, we remove the part with the hot spot to put in the right waste filière, waste treatment. If I have one more minute, the two last slides is just to show that, in fact, the robots are already installed in nuclear for a few years now, but in dismantling operation. The case shown now is that in a facility of LAG, we have historical waste to retrieve from a silo. But as you can see, this waste have no identified shape. Sorry, and so we will have to take back all this waste and to separate aluminium, magnesium from the graphite. So we don't have just to take them and put a drum. We have to take and sort the waste, identifying aluminium and magnesium. For this, we use an installation, and we work with Silean again. The robots are used here to isolate each waste. In fact, the waste are taken from a bulk here, and they are isolated. So then we can analyze the shape of each waste, and with artificial intelligence, we will define if it is aluminium, magnesium, or other, and so take the decision. Okay, I think I have finished. This is the last one, just to show that we are now working on deploying robots in different dismantling operation. Here it is a TO600 for laser cutting of two dissolvers, or cutting of other tanks, and so on. So, just to the aim of this second part of the presentation was to show that we are going to work more and more with the system that already exists in the industry in order to minimize the cost, but also to use all this technology that are mature out in other industry. Okay, thank you very much. If we have any question about TO600, DeRosa, or Wallam, we are on the Orano stand just behind you.